would like to welcome you to Kingsland Baptist Church. It is our joy to have you here tonight. I'm Pastor Jay Bonjack, and I'm going to ask Ken Thomas if he'll stand right now. I want to recognize him. He's our Minister of Music and Senior Adults, and he is the director of the program tonight. Let's give Ken a hand, please. We'd like for you who are visiting, if you would do us a favor, we'd like to have a record of your visit with us. And some of our ushers will come now and we'll hand you a business card or a business packet. If you just raise your hand so they might identify you, we'd like you to complete that business card right now so that we might ask you to put that in the offer plate. If you raise your hand right now so that they might identify you and give you a business packet information. Some up here at the front. We appreciate you being with us tonight. We are excited about the wonderful experience we will have tonight. Our sanctuary choir and drama team presents for you this very special program. And I know you're going to receive a blessing as you celebrate Christ with us. At the end of the service will be a time of expressing your praise and adoration to the Lord. I hope you're prepared as you've been with this experience tonight. Give adoration to the Lord Jesus himself. Thank you. God bless you for being with us.
I'm going to ask the ushers to come forward in a few minutes as we sing together Silent Night, Holy Night. I'm going to ask you to stand and we're going to be singing this a cappella. And I'm hoping that this will give those of you who are getting a business card, and I'm trying to install for a little time so everybody can get one. Please take this business card and fill it out real quickly because we're going to be having an offering in just a few moments. Go ahead and fill it out right now. And so if you need to remain seated while we do this, just go ahead and remain seated. I'm going to ask everyone else just to stand at this time. And we're going to sing Silent Night, Holy Night, all is calm, all is bright, round yonder. We can sing this together. I think everybody knows that you don't need any music here. And ask the ushers as we sing them to come on down. And then following the ushers coming down, we'll be singing a song. They follow the star, which will precede our musical tonight by our choir and our drama team, entitled Adoration, In Search of a King. The wise men sought him then, but wise men still seek him today. Let's sing together.
Hey! when a new star appeared in the heavens, Neville was not surprised when he felt compelled to study it. However, he was surprised when he discovered that the star seemed to move as if to entice him to follow. Even more, he was perplexed about a vision that he had, a vision that so moved him that he began a journey, a search for a newborn English king.
Thank you.
wondering where it would lead next, wondering if this mysterious holy pilgrimage would ever end. Suddenly, as though it had marked the spot where the royal treasure lay, the star seemed to pause over an Arabian marketplace.
Oh,
star remained in its place, still melting nor waiting in the marketplace. His fire seemed to draw other travelers.
Thank you.
blinding star led them to Jerusalem. The Magi heard about this place, the center of Judaism. It was no surprise then when the star blew it there. After all, where else but in the holy city would a Jewish king be born? Yet as they entered the gate, what they found raised even more questions. No celebration going on in the temple courtyard. In fact, they found no one in the temple except a common beggar.
Excuse me, we are trying to see. We are wondering, where is the
Thank you.
If that little way through the great city of Jerusalem to the nearby village where it came to rest over a very humble little dwelling. Just outside they found a young man, a Jewish man. The Magi introduced themselves and began to tell him about the star and their search for the king. Yet before they could explain, the man smiled as though he had been expecting them. He began to tell the Magi about his vision, his dream. The young man described his own journey to Bethlehem, the night in the innkeeper's stable, and the marvelous moments when God's Son drew his very first breath. And then there was the invitation, an open door to approach the King of Kings. As the Magi saw him for the first time, they knew their journey had not been in vain. Each one gave his gift. Each one embraced the moment. Each one bowed down before the living God. Thank you. bidding his traveling companions farewell, Melchior suddenly remembered the promise he had made, a promise to present a gift on behalf of his daughter. But the gift, the child's gift so lovingly given, had somehow been broken during the journey. How can he stand before the king with an imperfect offering? Yet how can he not fulfill their promise to his daughter? Feeling ashamed of the broken gift, yet knowing he should withhold nothing, the call came again. Come and worship. It was like hearing it for the first time. Perhaps that was the worship after all, laying everything, even the doubt, the fear, all the imperfections before a holy God.
Thank you. Jesus Christ, He is Lord. You cannot bow, kneel down in your seat. Would you kneel down in your heart and adore our Lord? He is worthy of all of your praise and honor and glory. And we must give it to Him, face and act. And I am bowing down to you. And I ask this congregation now, if you will do that, but if you do not know Christ and your Lord and Savior, I invite you to come tonight to lay the most precious gift you have at the feet of Jesus, the gift of yourself. Because if you receive Christ as your personal Savior, by faith, trusting in Him, you may be born again. You can truly know Jesus personally, your Lord and Savior. I would ask you to sing now. You would come and take my hand and say, Pastor, I give myself to the Lord tonight. I ask the rest, if you know Christ as your Savior, would you find a way to bow down to the Lord God Almighty, suspend the aisle or in your seat?